All right, round three, game two. We're not gonna play first, and you know, they say it's the bomb format. Well, show me the bombs this game. This hand is actually fantastic. We're definitely not gonna mulligan. It's got good removal, it's got a good creature. Trying to burn enrage, obviously fantastic. And all I need is to make sure that I draw my bombs this time. Because seriously, Elesh Norn. Ugh. It's not fun getting Norned. Alrighty, so either Porcelain Legionnaire or the Shrine. Probably Legionnaire, even though Perilous Mere stops it in its tracks. The same is true that the Legionnaire stops the Perilous Mere from attacking. So that's something. I mean, other options was like Grim Affliction, Perilous Mere, but that doesn't seem the best. I think I can happily sit back behind a Porcelain Legionnaire. Well, there you go, there's another one. Yeah, well, I'm not blocking. Ooh, Umbrask is good. I guess I don't mind trading Legionnaire for Legionnaire. I guess that's fine. I'll run out this shrine and yeah, offer the trade. I mean, it's all gonna get better once I have Urabrask on the table. Yeah. Fortunately, this whip flare is looking a bit awkward in my hand at the moment. Hopefully, I see a non-artifact creature from my opponent. I know he's got lots of them. Or I could hold on to it for goblin tokens, maybe. We shall see. So, if my opponent attacks with both, I just snap block Legionnaire. Legionnaires cancel each other out. That's fine. Or Tumble Magnet. Okay. Tapping down Legionnaire. Alrighty. I see. Well, I've got removal, so I don't need to concern myself too much about these beats. I'm gonna leave Porcelain Legionnaire back to block again. Yeah, and I'll probably end up using Grim Affliction for the Porcelain Legionnaire. I assume Tumble Magnet's gonna tap it down again. Hopefully I don't see a Slash Panther here, that would be pretty devastating. Oh, speak of the devil. Okay, so I guess I'm using Grim Affliction for Slash Panther then, and taking another four, going down to nine. Okay. Grim Affliction. Alright, so that sorts that out. So nine, yeah, I'm getting pretty low, but I've still got plenty of cards. We should be doing all right. Okay, so I can run out Umbrask. Do I want to attack with Umbrask? No. I'm just gonna leave him back to block. Yeah, just because he has haste doesn't mean he has to attack the first turn you play him. He's perfectly fine. Making my opponent's creatures come into play tapped. Is quite a good little ability there. So if my opponent attacks with Perilous Mere, I'll just block with Urabrask. I assume that's how this is going to play out. Sure. I mean, if you've got the removal spell for Urabrask, well, yeah, it happens. No, it's just going to kill a Porcelain Legionnaire. That's fine too. So, yeah, my opponent's holding on to his last counter on Tumble Magnet for posterity. And finally, a creature that I can kill with Whip Flare. But it's a creature that I'm not really concerned about. Damn. Alright, but I am gonna have Chancellor next turn. Sweet. Yeah, we're gonna hold on to this Whip Flare. And sit back to block. Yeah, well, we're not gonna block. I appreciate that. I guess I'll be using Shrine to kill Porcelain Legionnaire to keep my life total in a better place. Because I don't really want to open myself up to artillerize or things like that. Plenty of direct damage spells that could really cause problems for me. All right, but I mean, a hasty chancellor is nice too. But yeah, I really don't want to open myself up to being killed by artillerize. That's not what I want to do. Don't want to give my opponent the opportunity to win this one. I mean, I've got two of my bombs, so show me your bomb that costs 4 mana. You know what I'm saying? That's not gonna cut it. So that's an artifact creature as well. What's with all these artifact creatures? All right, so run out the Chancellor and bash for 6 and gain 6 life. Yeah, seems good. So then that completely negates Tanadon beats. And I'm also getting in for 6. Yeah. Boom. So that puts me back up to 14. So I can quite happily take all the damage from the Tanadon. Because I would like to hold on to my Umbrask for now. Or Urabrask. I want to say Umbrask. But no, Urabrask. Chancellor of the Dross. Okay. Alright, we're gonna have the Tanadon thundering in. Yeah, I'm not too worried. Puts me back to 9. I think I'm happy to go back to 9. Alrighty, and something else. So, there's potential that I could just randomly kill my opponent here. We'll see. Sensor Splicer. Alright, so Whip Flare's gonna be good here. So maybe I just randomly. Yeah, I do randomly kill my opponent. Awesome. So, I cast Whip Flare. Boom. And bash a 10. Yeah, good little tech right there. Oh, Goldmere's still around? That's right, he didn't tap it. I guess I leave a Umbras back and just bash for the 6. That's fine. Despise or Glistening Oil, I could use. I mean, I could Glistening Oil the Golem, and then I don't have to worry about it. It's not certainly not going to poison me to death. I'd rather look at my opponent's hand here, so that there's not something huge and scary like Elesh Norn that's going to randomly kill me. Because my opponent could very well have Elesh Norn in his hand, draw a land. Well, I'm not sure that even kills me. Umbras goes to a 2/2. Tanadon is 7, Golem is 5, which I block, so I take 10. So even Elesh Norn doesn't kill me exactly. The flying Chancellor. I mean, the white has a flying Chancellor, which is bigger. Well, that's funny. It is Elesh Norn. I don't think it's even relevant. Even if it had hit the table, because I'd still kill with Chancellor next turn. Because it gets in for 6 here, and then if it got in for 4, it'd still up fly over and kill my opponent. So if Elesh Norn did come in, yeah, my opponent had the land. Funny. I don't think it mattered. Let's do the math here. So Golem, I block all of is 5, 3 there and 2 there is 7 is 10, puts me to 5, and then I bash back for 4 in the air. So even then it doesn't matter, but feels good despising an Elesh Norn. Right. On to the next round. And by next round, I mean next game, obviously. Yeah. So, game 3, I like what I've got. Let's continue on. Obviously, I need lots of removal from my opponent's aggressive beats. I mean, do I want to bring in, say, Darksteel Mirror? Nah, I'd rather just have stuff that trades. It's all good. We're gonna continue on. Yeah, let's go.